I took time.
Isn't it supposed to be burgundy?
Look at Molly, see you.
Oh,
oh my
God.
So, the onesie?
So, we were talking just a little bit ago, and we think that Christ is probably too a little controversial. Can we change your name to, like, Tent City Immaculate Son? Is that an issue?
Tent City Dogfucker.
Dogfucker.
That's what I'm going with.
Is that the proper way to say it?
Right?
Yeah.
That seems pretty close.
And you're like pretty
positive
that's
that
all day.
I think that actually happens in downtown.
It probably does. There's probably a lot worse that goes on over there.
Podcast is for an adult audience. The Dirty Dowdy Podcast may contain material that may be unsuitable for sensitive ears. Listener discretion is advised. It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
Well, here it is, Dirty Dowdy Podcast. Running a little late, but I'm doing a little double duty tonight. If you see my Facebook post, you'll know what I'm talking about. Little long box, a little 104.1 with the magic that is radio. We're doing it up here, though, tonight. The Longbox.FM studios brought to you by Riley's Brewing.
Cheers.
Por favor, gracias, Riley's.
Kenneth, week to week, do you intend to come in here and be a downer with that cheers? Because you drink the majority of the beer.
I was being positive.
Oh, man, you and I are going to have to chat. Like, if we roll back the tape a year ago, start of the show, it's like brought to you by Rallies. You're cheers!
That's because I've been hanging around you for a year.
And then we got mad at you for being too loud. So now it's like, okay, and thanks to our number one sponsor, you're like, yeah, they're okay.
So you're telling me that
they're fantastic. Yay.
Wait, so what
I'm
you're telling...
I'm trying here.
So what you're saying is that hanging around without Dowdy is like hanging around in an AA meeting?
No, definitely not as much as fun as an AA meeting.
We're not at things we learned yet, but hold that into your mind there. we got a bunch going on. We'll get to it. The phone number, 492-0450. You can hit us up, chat with anybody in the room, our guests, all that, play along with our games. Well, you know how we do it up. You can also hit us up. Vanna will be live tweeting on Twitter, our hashtag, at LongboxFM. Cotty is watching the YouTube chat room, and I'm watching the Facebook live chat room because we're all over the place. Not to mention, we didn't really talk about it last week, but we are soon going to be on CMAC now. So these shows are going to be broadcast in their entirety, unedited, on TV.
Wow.
I don't know what they were thinking. The guy who offered it to me has been on this show.
Did he actually meet you in person?
Yes. He was here in the studio, and then when I sat and talked to him, I said, hey, Brian, man, you've been on the show. You know what we do, right? And he goes, that's all right. It's cable. I'm like, okay. I'm not going to talk myself out of TV here.
Fair enough.
You go ahead and broadcast us. Go ahead.
I'm a real boy.
And then you can see if you're watching the video cameras here, we got a gorgeous platter of sushi in front of us from our new sponsor. We'll be hitting it up all season, football season long, Kunisama. We did the live drink and draft this last Saturday, and you'll be hearing updates on that as I know Ben is a part of it, and IP4 in the background, who doesn't have a mic because he's a trainee, and once he even becomes a sound guy, he still won't have a mic. He was a part of it too, so week to week shit talk as we do our thing there.
He's officially been renamed to Fisher Price.
Who, this guy? Because he's a toy we play with?
Yes.
more like Fishy Pete.
Occasionally just drop him in the toilet on accident.
You try to give him a swirly, and what happens?
Well, swirly this, buddy boy. It's longbox.fm. We have a lot of podcasts on there. Go and check it out. We're getting some updates to the website coming. And as of yesterday, looks like we're headed towards having an app. So all those people are having trouble figuring out how to listen to us consistently without your phone always being on. That is coming. That may come around the time of, I don't know, let's just say this Festivus thing coming, which... keep listening this month. All the news on that is coming out soon.
I hear it's going to be big.
I'm hearing that I've bit off more than I could chew this year, so I don't know how the hell I'm going to pull this off.
I mean just this year.
It's...
You mean you won't be in a fetal position?
As I describe every year,
still will be.
I have a routine when it comes to Festivus. I get all excited when I start planning it in February or March.
And then he starts doing it.
Yeah. I get all excited and hopeful. I cover my windows and any glass surface with wax pen as I come with more and more ideas. And then right around late October, early November, I start saying, fuck Festivus. I'm done with this shit. Another week after that, a laptop or some other expensive piece of equipment will be thrown in anger. Then this glimmering hope that maybe this is all going to work. We do the show, and then I curl up on the floor in front of the couch and cry like a little baby for the next week and a half because I was exhausted. So that's I think we're getting ready for stage three here coming pretty soon.
Of your fake cancer, or
no, that was last year's thing. I'm not allowed to talk about that this year. That was my New Year's resolution. But
all right, folks. So what we've actually been talking about is the 10th annual Dowdy's Mouthful, is what it really is.
Nah. Ben, I hate you, and oh, you get to go first this week. And things we learned.
Now it's time to showcase what we have learned in the last week.
And of course, this is brought to you by Kunisama. Go check them out on the corner of Herndon and Willow. Right there in the Walmart parking lot. The food is fantastic. Lots of taps up there for you to select and choose. And Ben, what did you learn?
I've learned, actually, this is my second time since we've changed out these lights. And I've learned that since we've changed out these lights up here, I feel less like a voice on the radio than I do a goddamn turtle in a terrarium.
Blinded by the light.
Wrapped up like a douche.
Jinx, you owe me a Coke.
I believe that that
Riley's
is
a, root beer.
Right. Ben, that's
would
a
be some Coke.
Pretty solid description, because I take what I have in this room, which is, you know, less than talent, and I figure if I put the lights on hard enough, I might grow some out of you guys.
Oh,
oh shit! What am I, a pot plant?
Just I need LED lights and organic water.
They call me
the full spectrum.
Sounds like Roadie Mac.
They call me the foot cheese. So grow that.
Ugh. Our guest tonight, Mr. Tent City Christ himself, Levi. What did you learn?
Syphilis is alive and well in Fresno.
Syphilis? I was like, symbolics or syphilis? Okay.
No, syphilis.
So rough weekend?
Rough.
Yeah. Little groupies. Little hot and itchy. It's like dragging your
that
dick.
That never happened.
It's like dragging your dick through insulation.
Yeah, all the fiberglass.
Yeah, just it gets in there.
It's like smoking a Camel.
Extra friction. Or, I mean,
so by the
put
way,
some coconut oil on it.
The answer to everything. Sucking my dick in Windex.
I think it says that on the bottle. You're not supposed to do that. Specifically, don't put your dick in the bottle.
Parentheses, but if you must.
Submerge for 5 minutes.
I'm Tent City Christ, and I support this message.
All right. The one-man band's need for a roadie brings us Roadie Mac. What did you learn this week?
I learned that if you're a smart person and you make stupid people feel stupid, then you're a dick.
So you've been hanging out with Ben before the show.
Yeah, but I can only make Mac feel stupid so many times before it really
before he feels like a dick.
Shots fired. Shots fired.
I would say game on at this point.
You said last week. You didn't say this week.
Ooh, wait a minute.
That's true. There was a cutoff. Vanna, you were late, but did you learn anything?
I did. I learned that I'm a hypochondriac. And I should calm the hell down. I convinced myself that I had lupus over this weekend, and then I convinced myself that like I had an allergic reaction to all the bug bites that I got here at the Longbox Studios. And yeah, I got some blood drawn because of it. And
you're fine.
I'm fine.
She caught the HIV from the station.
Turns out you have syphilis.
No, actually, I
You know what it is? You know what it is?
It's I have that nothing. That's my problem. I'm a hypochondriac.
You know what it is? It's that urine swamp next to the air conditioner out back, and they've been working on irrigating that thing for a while.
I try to pee that soil healthy.
I have a bug
that's
fan.
That's not how it
so
works.
I agree. I don't think that.
That's using my mind. Walmart 2 for $1.
And Dowdy, isn't it like you trying to fuck yourself like handsome, or how does that work?
So what I've learned this week, I've learned that we have yet another audience, one I did not mention in the beginning. Welcome, Washington.
Hello.
I had a little phone call this week with our sponsor, Mr. Riley himself, and we were discussing HSR and all that stuff, and he was talking about how, you know, he would love to shoot up one of those offices.
Oh,
and
God.
Then I said, don't you kind of want to just, you know, sweater vest bomb it? And he goes, oh, yeah. I'm like, but, you know, I mean, you'd be killing yourself. And he's like, I don't know what would be the better way. Do you go in and just, you know, he's like, I have specific people that I would take out. and I said, well, yeah, you could go in and do it. He goes, but do I just shoot them and then come out and, like, do the good thing and surrender myself, martyr myself that way like I did it for the system? Because he's getting royally raped right now by HSR. And I said, no, well, you know, to go on a holy jihad of beer. And then at this point, I realized we've said almost all the key words that you need to say on a phone to make sure people are listening. So I stopped and I said, hold on, Dan. By the way, thank you, Washington and NSA, for listening. You can find us on Longbox.FM. We're on every Wednesday night. Carry on, Dan. And then it went on to more terrorist-related stuff. So we have an audience.
I learned that I need to be better friends with Danny Riley.
Dan's my favorite Republican.
Yeah.
He is.
So yeah, we're on a watch list. If we had gotten off originally, oh, I remember the follow up. I talked about it'd be funny with one day I go to the airport and I'm not allowed on because of the no fly list. Like I'm packing a bomb. So now I've mentioned bomb, airplane, airport, no fly. It's like we're screwed here.
I thought you said packing a bong, and I got excited.
See, you're on a different list.
We have to go, Mac.
I come in peace.
I'm out
in search of peace.
I have nothing.
I'm getting on weed.
You're literally
now.
Vanna. You're literally on the no-fly zone.
I'm already up there, so it's cool.
She's already Christ. So high.
Elevated, hella stated.
Well, tell you what, let's do this. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, we're going to be hitting up. Now, Vanna, you're sitting in for Alex this week on the Clambake, and I've seen a little screenshot of, well, you've taken a lot of time. Sorry, I have to say this. Vanna's done a very good job of making the pictures look really good. She made a point to make sure that we all knew that before she came in. So make sure during this next segment, look at all the pictures and give her loves and props. You can find her on Twitter. It's Vanna.
Vanna YOLO.
I love that your eyes are rolling into the back of your head to that whole statement.
You got to make your quote-unquote talent happy. This is a Dirty Dowdy podcast here in Longbox.fm Studios. We'll be right back.
Listening to the Dirty Dowdy podcast on Longbox.fm. Doesn't it suck to run out of cell phone minutes? I agree. So if you got no minutes to spare and you still want to share, hit up Longbox.fm on Skype by calling Longbox.fm. You'll get Dirty Dowdy and the rest of the Longbox crew. So whether you got minutes to share or none to spare, hit us up on Skype at Longbox.fm.
Hi, my name is Lindsay, and I'm searching for love.
I want to do music because I know people need my music. People need Kanye West albums.
My real apology to her will not come in the form of words.
When people say that I'm not like an airhead and things like that, it's not true at all.
All the stupid things celebrities do, it's the Celebrity Clambake.
Here we go, the Celebrity Clambake. On the Longbox.fm network, the Dirty Dowdy podcast here, sponsored and brought to you as always by Riley's Brewing.
Cheers!
Now, see,
I love the beer!
Oh my God,
throw
dude.
The beer at me.
Kenneth, oh, that mute button is coming back.
Your
God
fault.
Damn it, Kenneth.
Totally your fault.
You asked.
You asked for it. Asked. I gave you enthusiasm, you ass.
No, that wasn't enthusiasm.
That was such enthusiasm. It was happiness.
You're like the kid
form.
Who got into grandma's pills.
Grandma's pills was whiskey, so
so she put the pills in the whiskey bottle.
No, it was just
channel?
Whiskey.
That's you know.
It was more organic.
It was all sour mash aspirin.
Less chemicals. All Yay. Right, so let's get into this clam bake.
Look
y'all
at you taking control.
Yeah, all right. So Colin Kaepernick, I'm taking control because Colin has inspired me.
Oh, wow.
So Colin Kaepernick, I don't even know if I'm
saying Minority
Kaepernick.
Report.
I don't watch football, but I like this guy.
Slap a
Number dick. 7, 49ers jersey is now number 1 in sales, and Colin is donating the profits to charity he just announced today. For those of you guys who don't remember, he is the 49ers football player who sat down during the Pledge of Allegiance.
No, it's
interesting.
National anthem.
No, it's the same thing to me. I don't like. I said I don't watch football.
Oh man,
or no American song. America.
That was
but
rather governmental.
I don't know America.
I don't know what America.
Well, I'm gonna be one of the. I don't know what's more un-American: sitting down or not watching football.
Ooh, good Ooh. Right.
So you're Kaepernick times two.
I am.
Ghost well, sports. Actually, no. You know, Kaepernick doesn't really play football either.
Doubty, you promise?
He just throws, right?
Suck.
Does he?
That dude's getting benched.
Well, that dude's jersey is now number one, and that is the news. But he's donating his profits to charity.
Wait, number one
what?
Where?
Wait, it's what? Number one in sales. His jersey's number one in sales.
They sell,
has the highest selling jersey already.
They
like
sell his jersey in Syria?
I was going to say... I think it's Abu Dhabi, but you know I could be mistaken.
I don't know. Our listener Abu in Abu Dhabi, let us know. Not the one that was all about Breonna Banks. The other guy that we actually like. Go ahead.
Speaking of,
I thought he was the same guy.
No, that second guy had a sticky hand, man. You could hear it through
Ew.
The phone.
Oh.
Wait, which guy are we talking
You weren't
about?
Here.
Speaking
oh, good.
Of us.
Oh, good.
Speaking of sexually transmitted diseases, the World Health Organization now says that gonorrhea, chlamydia, and syphilis are becoming untreatable and unresponsive to your standard antibiotics, which ties into Tent
Rap.
City Christ's story.
And it is alive and well in
Rap.
Fresno.
He's sitting well. Right here.
Let this be a warning. They are not Pokemon. You do not need to catch them all.
What?
Oh, Jesus.
I'm doing it
I
wrong.
I might have to write that down.
I was hoping to get all of them on my dick, and then it would evolve.
Yes.
So it becomes a petri dish of bullshit at that point.
I wanted to shoot lightning.
They're just going to name them Doughty 1, Doughty 2. They're going to run out of names.
Well, I was hoping for the herpes so that the warts would grow and make my dick bigger.
Yes, variety.
You'd literally be Silver nicknamed lion. The hammerhead at that point.
So sorry, horn would make me.
The horn beetle.
Can we please move on?
Oh, all right.
Call it the hive.
No, I came dressed festive for this next story. Yeah. Former NWA manager Jerry Heller's attorney states that Straight Outta Compton led to his death. Sources state Whoa. That the 75-year-old was distraught, which led to his heart attack, which led to a car accident, which led to him dying. But don't worry. His nephew heard of the fatal accident and came with his iPod loaded with NWA songs, so he passed away listening to Straight Outta Compton.
Wow. That sounds horrible.
He's straight out of life.
Yeah. Eazy-E's daughter is actually making a documentary currently, which is going to be released later this year or next year, stating how Heller was inaccurately portrayed in the Straight Outta Compton movie.
Holy cow.
Well, I think she's a day late and a dollar short, considering that Straight Outta Compton pretty much inaccurately portrays Jerry Heller, except for the fact that he was a coke-infested, crab-holding bastard.
What?
Harsh.
Huh?
Huh?
Rest in peace.
Rest in peace, Jer.
What the fuck?
Actually, Ice Cube was showed him that he did an interview earlier and was just saying that he was impartial to his death. So... You and Ice Cube share that in common.
Yes, we do.
Yeah. By the way, Levi,
how cool.
Danny Minch says, Lee loves me some... God damn it. Love me, Levi.
Love me, Levi.
Tell Danny, thank you.
Sir.
Oh, wow, that
thank
wasn't
you,
funny either.
Oh.
Vanna shooting. There's just shots fired all over this table tonight.
Fucking sitting here across
from
the Tent
City. I'm gangster today. I'm wearing my NWA shirt. The hoop earrings are off. All right, so I'm going to Apple. I'm leaking myself here. All right, so
are you this excited because you don't have a disease? Is this
yes.
the hypochondriac's like need for a
yes.
release?
This is her masking the fact
no,
that she does have
No, this is me excited because
disease.
There's sushi in front of me, so
oh
it's a good
Oh, my God.
Day.
I don't know how to
it
calm
is a
you
good
down.
Day.
There is no way.
Nope, there's no way. I'm going to go all Apple over here. So Apple just leaked its own iPhone 7 images and details on Twitter. This comes as really funny news because Tim Cook was holding back during an interview and presentation, and at the same time he was speaking, this Twitter tweet leaked.
Yeah.
Wow.
So new cameras, water resistant, stereo speakers, longer battery life. This is 7.
Yeah, but it doesn't have a headphone jack.
It also doesn't fly and take selfies automatically.
Does it give you a blowjob, for fuck's sake?
Yeah, come on.
Any difference.
Only the Japanese model.
Looks like the back of my eye.
Attachment sold separately.
It's a
Bluetooth enabled.
God damn it! It's a Bluetooth enabled.
I don't know where to write
it. It would have been funny had you guys not stepped all over me. Damn it.
You needed a good stepping.
It was still hilarious.
You know, I saw the side port on that phone, and there's not a goddamn hole small enough.
Well, now that I have the warts.
What?
Dowdy's got the hive.
Holy shit!
Just one
compounded
single hive.
Cock syndrome.
All right.
Next story.
Yeah, so Motley Crue is currently being sued over
Speaking
their farewell tour merchandise. And why is that thing covering up my super nice graphic? Show my graphic to the people. Motley sued. So they're currently being sued. I'm gonna pause and enjoy the spot. Alright. So Motley Crue is currently being sued by photographers Barry Levine and Niels Lowzauer.
Well done.
What?
Yeah, Lowzauer.
Super enough.
You know, probably should have spent more time learning the name.
It's okay because they're suing, so we're so far off their radar, right?
Well, they're not suing us.
Yeah. I altered those images enough, so let's be clear. So they're being sued currently for not giving any credit at all to their merchandise for the last farewell. So they're making a big stink about it. Yeah, don't use our pictures.
So this is another day in the life for Motley Crue, considering how much each one of those guys has been sued.
Sure, next story.
I can't name a time they've been sued, but wow. I would like to sue Tommy Lee for giving me false impersonations of rock stars and what they should be able to perform like. Anyway.
You mean him and Pam Anderson, right? Because that's what that sounded like that was aimed
at.
Another man with
warts. So Kanye West was actually, his writer got leaked due to Kim Kardashian's Snapchat.
What the
She just Snapchatted a Snapchatty of the Pablo Rider.
A
saying
Snapchatty?
That it is, I don't know. I don't Snapchat. I'm not a slut. Pablo Rider is lit.
Shots thrown!
Which is frozen Hennessy and Coke and a frozen Grey Goose with lemonade. And you'd think he'd have a more expensive vodka. I'm just saying.
You'd think he'd get a blender full of talent and drink that before he got on stage. Just grind up any musician around and hope he can soak it in.
Ooh. Well, he went after Motley Crue, but they sued him.
No, you went too far, man.
I don't care.
Yeah, I'm going to take me a Jay-Z cappuccino at this point.
That guy's got no talent.
I don't know. That's an alcoholic squishy, and he's okay with me.
Jesus.
I don't know. All right.
Wow, we're dying.
Yeah. Next story. Let's pick it up. We need to medicate this. So
let's go bloody.
Marijuana tampons are officially a thing, you guys.
Mary you
and tampons? That's totally not me endorsing.
No,
it
that
right
is
there.
You right there.
Yes.
I am not wearing a dress with pot leaves that Dowdy is covering up.
Wait a minute. Let me see your
Dowdy is covering up right now.
Let's
that's you with a tampon in you.
It's in my mouth though.
All right, so I'm not the only one.
That was a bad joke. No, that's actually a Cloud Vape pen, which is a proud sponsor of mine. Thank you, Cloud Vape.
Did you have that in you?
Is that
no, I did not. But the story goes that Fora is now the only medical marijuana company that has medicated tampons, which they conveniently call suppositories, each containing 60 milligrams of THC. And the benefits of this is that it causes cramps to disappear.
Huh. Because she...
There's
so much.
It's actually a THC concentrated alcohol-based oil.
How beautiful.
Yeah.
Okay, so some company read the story of high school kids soaking tampons in vodka and shoving them up inside them to get
high. That's a thing?
Oh, my God, Vanna.
Where the hell have you been?
I didn't know my things could do that.
The first, last, and only millennial not to know it.
Yeah. Dudes were shoving tampons soaked in vodka up their asses to get drunk at school.
Guys were doing it, too?
Yeah, I used to just take vodka to school. In a Sprite bottle.
I thought you were going to say you just used to straight ass shoot it like a real man.
Seriously.
Yeah.
Hey, that bottle of pop-off was his butt plug.
I've never understood the idea, the concept. Kids want to get drunk at school, so they shove things up their ass. Or like the hold me upside down, guys, and shove this bottle in my ass so I can absorb it faster. Like, what is your deal, man? Just drink it like a regular teenage, underage person.
But it tastes gross.
So shoving things in your ass is way better.
Our future is
I don't
is
have
so
to
fucked.
Taste that.
I'm technically still
That's
a virgin.
What she said.
So, Foria is selling this product online at $44 for a package of four tampons. And
what?
If they'd like to reach out to me, I am a California resident with a card. And if you'd like to send me four tampons for $44 at $11 per unit price for Vanna Vandal to try out, you can send them to the Longbox Studios.
Because all of Vanna's other sponsors have actually dropped her. So.
Vanna, how many weeks from now would you need those by?
I would need them in about 21 days.
Okay.
Yeah.
Give or take the next six
cycles noted.
Which would explain why I was bitchy last Wednesday.
Oh, just last Wednesday?
Oh, that's why.
Well, then.
I didn't know. It was a once a month thing.
That's how you That's how you shut her up.
Yeah. Hold on, Vanna.
I'm quiet because I'm contemplating your guys' death.
No, here you go.
Oh, my God. That's what I was going to say.
That's what I've been doing that for years.
Vanna, I put it on the screen again for you.
Thank you.
You happy?
It makes me happy. I worked really hard.
All right, now do your last story.
All right. So the last story comes as a tie-up to my other time. When I do the clam bake, I like to wrap up loose ends. And Abby Lee has actually pleaded guilty finally. And she faces up to 5 years in prison. And she just states that she's scared to death of prison.
So what's the Fatty Lee Dance
what
Company?
She do?
Oh my God! Every time I bring her up, you guys don't know who she is. Abby Lee Miller is a god in the dance community.
Holy
she has made several Broadway stars.
All right,
stars.
Quick, bring up that
look at the other
song
there
again.
There you go. Comente.
She's pretty fat to be a dancer.
I was going
to
say she's the equivalent of
the
choreographer.
She's the
equivalent of Buddha for the goddamn dance company.
Is your it the, Western beauty
what kind
standards
of
make me sad.
Her students include Barney and Big Bird.
This is Jesus.
Her students include
oh,
Nutty
I
Ziegler,
love you.
Who is Sia's muse.
And all 18 versions of the Nutty Professor. Just a skull.
Those who can't do, teach, right?
She did the choreography for Dora the Explorer.
So that is the
Kanye's
clam
next
bake.
Video.
I am going to need to bake a lot to get over this clam bake. So thank you guys for joining
oh,
me.
Oh, you just got next week. Called out your period.
No, damn well you're just going to attack this sushi plate.
Speaking of
right
which,
now.
Yes, it's time. We're going to be getting to the Kuni-sama. Shut up, I'm doing the thing.
Yes, we get you're doing
Kuni-sama, we got a beautiful platter that we're going to destroy here during the break. Brought to you, of course, like I said, Kuni-sama. You can find them on the corner of Herndon and Willow right there in the Walmart parking lot. We'll tell you how good it is after the break. We'll be right back. We're going to be interviewing the band Tent City Christ, the band being the one man and his roadie who has syphilis. So we'll be back with all that. It's the Dirty Daddy Podcast here on Longbox.fm.
Alright, so we're starting a pool to see how many pieces of sushi Vanna can fit in her mouth.
Oh my.
No! Because she will accept all challenges, and she will take all of them.
She'll take the whole fucking thing.
Did you actually grab a plate? Can
you freeze
yes, because the plates are the size of that plate.
Soy sauce?
Oh. Can we make a wasabi?
The wasabi's right there.
Everything's behind you.
Wait.
Can you make a wasabi?
Can
you touch
the...
Is it wasabi
don't
singular?
Touch the ginger.
Wasabi.
Wait, which ginger?
I'm good, bro.
You good?
Yeah. You should use this.
Okay. On the plate.
Not a fan of how soft these are.
Massive shrimp. Oh my god, get over hypochondriac.
How long is your break?
It's hypo.
Hey, look, food.
How long is your break?
Shut up and eat.
Nope, it's actually hypo.
Use restroom.
Yeah, put that over there. Enough for a cigarette and a refill, basically.
Yes.
Oh, sweet.
I can't drink anymore. I'm gonna be too drunk. Just try this one.
This guy.
I love sushi rolls with clover inside.
He handed it to me. You're more than welcome.
What's that with the was that the sweet sour hot sauce or whatever? The other on Saturday, now? Mm.
What?
There was sushi here on Saturday?
I don't see another one.
No, you weren't here.
I like football, I think.
So, nope.
Actually, Vanna, if I remember correctly, I did invite you to come bring your boyfriend.
My boyfriend was supposed to play a show, and then his stupid drummer quit.
And then you didn't get sushi, so it was real lose-lose for you.
Yeah, it was. But I got laid, so it's cool.
within 21 days.
Man, I hate my life.
How could you? This shit's dope.
Yeah, okay.
It's not late enough in the evening.
Yeah, seriously.
Wait,
why? I'm surprised. It's been like a DDP light so far.
Yeah, I know. Everybody's getting some good shots in on everybody.
You just got way too high to talk for a minute.
You're fucking way.
Hey, what's going on? This is Tom Arnold, and when I'm at a Cocaine Anonymous meeting, I'm usually in the back listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast. I love painkillers.
It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
All right, the Dirty Dowdy Podcast is back here in the Longbox.fm studios, brought to you, of course, by Riley's Brewing.
Cheers.
Cheers, Riley's.
And I'm pretty sure everybody has filled up mightily since it's a destroy. We can't even put that on camera, guys. That's just embarrassing. The sushi platter from Kunisama is gone. My crew, I'm not even going to blame our guests tonight. My crew is just...
I had one roll. Literally one roll.
Next time you come back, you'll learn a lesson.
I went out to smoke, and it came back and was gone.
That's your lesson. Don't go outside.
Every time we get food here, it's before I even get it, it's gone. I go out and get the endorsement. Anyways, yeah, Kunisama, you could get him on the corner of Herndon and Willow, right there in the Walmart parking lot. Go hang out with Matt. Mm. He's the bartender there. He's a part of our Longbox.fm Drink and Drive League, and I'm going up against him this week. A sure domination victory because he chose Julian Edelman in the second round. He's a moron. And for all the non-sports balls knowing people, we're hanging out here with the band Tent City Christ. You know, I got to admit, it's tough to call you the band Tent City Christ because you are the man Tent City Christ.
That's right.
But I have been hearing that you're auditioning tonight, actually.
Yeah, we do have a drummer, and tonight we are auditioning a new bass player.
I play bass.
Do you play bass?
Oh, my God, Vanna. Food, instrument.
Holy shit. I think that's a lesson to learn.
Roll was literally falling out of her mouth.
Hey, you know, it shows she's committed. I like the dedication and the drive, really.
And enthusiasm.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Some more sushi.
Just an orange amp and a Hofner and a Vox cable.
Okay.
So
do you notice
very British setup? I hope you don't mind.
Do you notice how subdued she is on this?
Right.
The last segment, it was like, so we got Kanye West doing whatever. And this, so I've got an orange case and.
Hashtag medication.
I made this poster for you, Dowdy. Yeah.
I made the poster!
Now, if we can find... Oh.
It was a collage?
Damn it.
Show everybody!
I mean, damn it. I have totally lost control.
Call me crew graphic, damn it.
This show is off the rails. Off the rails, I say.
Isn't it pretty?
Say it's pretty!
Kenneth!
It's Kenneth. Pretty!
Oh, Kenneth. My God!
Only open your mouth for drink now. God, you're impossible.
Yeah. Dude took my beer.
Jesus Christ, prom date. If he doesn't say anything, you're fucking pissed.
Hey, Levi, you control your roadie, I'll control mine.
Fair enough.
Or, later on in the show, we're going to have a roadie fest. A roadie off.
Yeah, there you go.
Kenneth Kenneth versus Mac.
Dukes. Dukes.
Mac's pretty badass. Look out, Kenneth.
No, it's going to be
like Braveheart in
I'm
here.
The shoulder monkey.
It's going to be a lemongrass growing competition.
I get
I said lemon basil, bitch.
What the fuck is lemongrass?
It's like lemons, but in the grass.
Oh, my God.
Absolutely wrong.
Interview.
That was actually a really intelligent conversation. Lemon basil is actually really great.
Oh,
for
my God.
Long
this
season.
Is getting worse.
This is the Vegan Power Hour brought to you by Riley's Brew.
Whoa. Thanks, no Riley's. One said vegan.
Now with coconut oil.
How dare you bring actually, that V word to my knowledge?
Riley's is gosh.
Hey, Riley's actually does have reduced gluten. So, like, they actually use a lot of natural gluten.
Riley,
I'm just saying. It's great beer.
Guys, Riley has called me right now and says he doesn't want to sponsor this anymore. If we're going to be doing vegan and attributing to him.
Understood.
Fair enough.
Remember, he's bombing people.
# canine teeth.
What the fuck? I don't get it, but okay.
I don't either.
So the
reel it in, Roadie. Reel it in.
# alcoholic G-dad.
Shut up! I think it's...
God.
Oh, Jesus. My skills are being tested right now. We have an interview.
You have skills.
We're wasting band time, guys. All right, so Levi, the man behind Tent City Christ. Real fast, man, give us a little history about Tent City Christ. Everything about it, and especially I do want to know the name. Because sure. I was expecting that we would have to have Bibles and tents.
Right?
Around.
Yeah, no. It does trip people up. I have a very extensive background with religion. I used to be a pastor. I'm currently non-religious, although I'm looking into Rastafarian just because, yeah. I mean, if it comes down to Creed or Bob Marley, what are you going to pick? You know? But anyway, I digress. So Tent City Christ, I've been a singer-songwriter for 15 years, and the last year and a half I've been full-time. So when I went full-time, I chose a stage name. And Tent City Christ, I went through a really hard time, basically lost everything. And when I was reduced down to my basic components, what I realized was I've always been a musician. And so music kind of saved me at my lowest point. And so when you think about a person who's, you know, in Tent City or is homeless or is going through a really hard time, so a lot of times they find faith. And I found faith in music. So that was my savior. And that's where the name comes from, Tent City Christ.
All right. I'm guessing no one has any negative comments to throw on that, Kenneth?
Nope.
That's punk rock and very Fresno, and I like it.
Dope.
Well, thank you. Thank you. I appreciate that.
And how long have you been out doing this?
So we've been full-time for the last year and a half, but I've been playing Fresno for 15 years. So
I'm sorry, man.
Yeah, me too. Well, it has its ups and it has its downs.
It's nothing like Reno.
That's enough out of you.
That's a lot of notes.
No negativity.
He's been making his bones in Chowchilla.
We've been playing some of your songs on Longbox and during the breaks there. If you're listening to this later, I'm sorry they got cut out, but we got something coming for you later. Singer songwriter ish, but you also you talk about reggae. And my next question for you actually is, why does reggae suck?
What?
Oh, today's are you referring to my meme?
Can I say shots?
Yeah. There it is.
Yeah, that's exactly how I feel. Did you see that look I just gave you? Like, what are you talking about?
Friendly. I'd like to just remind everybody that we do not all share the same viewpoints. As Chris Dowdy.
Yeah. Reggae for me, like, okay, and then I was a grunge baby, so I was, you know, I feasted my ears on what music was during the 90s grunge movement, and then, you know, you have Sublime and all these other great freaking bands who are just killing it, and so I really look up to those guys, and for me, reggae has always made me feel like, you know, just completely happy and chill.
So you liked marijuana more than heroin?
Right. Well, obviously.
That's not grunge at all.
You know. But yeah, and so I kind of, with this new project, I'm moving a little bit more toward Cali roots, although we're still Indian folk. So it's a combination of many different things. Years of ballad writing with blues is now being moved into reggae. And so it's a really cool mix. And I've got a new drummer we've been together for about 6 months. Just reads my mind. We cross states. He lives in Reno. I live here in Fresno. So, you know, we're really working hard on a lot of different things. And he's a Rastafarian. So he's very, very good at the one drop. So I really appreciate it.
Well, yeah, that's one thing on the music I've been listening to. I'm clearly not hearing reggae in it. It's hard to do when it's a singer-songwriter.
Right.
But obviously you've got it figured out where you can transition your songs to fit that mold. So
it's not all reggae. A lot of it has, you know, like a blues contemporary feel. But, you know, it depends on what song we're on our set, because then we'll switch straight back into, you know, straight reggae and things of that nature. So, you know, reggae is summer and a sound for me, so it's when I want to chill, and you know, but then every song that I write has a message and it's saying something. So if the song, I let the songs write themselves. So if it doesn't feel like that should be a reggae song, then it's not going to be. It's going to be whatever the song needs it to be.
Okay.
I don't know if that makes sense.
No, so you don't limit yourself to his
genre. Right. Yeah, exactly. Mm-mm.
Not at all. Well, we said this before the show even started, that you know, we grew up in an era where there were actual genres.
Right.
Where now they throw a label on it. Not really.
Genres per song.
Genre 0.5.
Yeah. You can have a mixtape of one artist with current artists now.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, and by the way, if you have any questions for our guests here, either Levi or his roadie, best way to, you know, load in something while super high and growing lemon, wheat, grass, basil.
Fucker.
You can call us 492-0450 or hit up the chat room. I'm watching the Facebook one, and Cuddy's got the YouTube under control there. So another question for you, and this is something that we go into with every band, something I'm very interested in and hoping to work towards a point.
Okay.
Fresno... Everyone says Fresno sucks. By the way, hashtag make Fresno better. Right. Everyone says Fresno sucks. The scene sucks. All this. There's been infighting forever. I think the last couple of years is starting to see a little bit of an uptick. But you still hear the little things here and there.
Right.
The question is bands versus promoters versus venues. I don't know if I should talk about this. No specific names. No specific names. That's not what we're looking for here. But what is it that's not working? What can be done better on all sides?
It's a very complicated issue because Fresno is a depressed region, and so it's one of the least fun places to play. The crowds are you just look out into a crowd at any of our big concerts, and you look at our Fresno people, and they just all seem like they're in a coma. And it differs everywhere you go. So part of it is the entire financial situation and situation of the valley in itself. You know, there are exceptions to every rule, but this rolls over into local bands and dealing with the venues and the promoters, because each of them are running a business and they're trying to get something. But a lot of times the bands take the brunt of, you know, basically you sell 30 tickets, you get $30, kinds of really bad positions where the musicians don't get paid. And then, you know, I don't know if this is like this everywhere else. So I don't know what the answer is, and I think we just need to...
What would you like to see... I'll get you, Roadie. What would you like to see as a layout for bands when it comes to... So you got a show coming up.
Right.
Let's say you're playing Festivus.
Okay.
How would you like the ticket sales thing be done that make you feel good about what you're doing?
Well, I don't want it to be a blatant... grab for money. I mean, you look at some of the deals that they're offering the artists, and it's pennies on the dollar for what the promoter are making. I mean, it's literally playing for free.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's no value in the band. You know, there's no value put toward the artists themselves. We're not important. That's how it makes you feel. And then you have to self-promote and self-sell all your tickets and then hope that Fresno turns out. And Fresno doesn't, folks. Mm-hmm. They don't. So it doesn't matter how good you are. It's you would want to see something that reflects more value of the artist from the promoter, I would feel.
The promoter. No, actually, I'm sorry. I walked on this. Roadie, you had something to say about that question.
The artist portraying their own art cannot do so in a successful manner without portraying some movement behind the art. So a lot of Levi's music involves revelations that he has come to, and occurrences and experiences in his life that have been more so detrimental than benevolent. When you create a benevolent effort or a benevolent situation for those people who are mindless zombies, apparently, to enjoy and follow, then they'll do so in an enthusiastic manner. But until you actually fulfill some type of movement with your art, they are simply lost zombies.
Okay, have this guy write all your bios and stuff because he uses the big words.
Well, thank you, Mac. I didn't know you felt that way.
I know. Oh. He kind of made gay love to you right now through the mic.
Are you a does anybody have a thesaurus?
No, but you've got warts of the ears now. Promoters, right. What in your mind, because if you're doing a show, likely these days now, you're working through a promoter or something. Right. What in your mind do you think a promoter should do for their part?
Well, it's in the job title. They need to promote the show. And one of the things you run into is promoters who slap something on Facebook and call it promotion. You know, or hand out 50 flyers to some intern who stands on the corner for 20 minutes. What's that going to do? You know, so I'm not in no way bashing all promoters because we have some really great promoters in the area. But there are some people who are obviously taking advantage of the artists. So if they're going to promote, you know, because they put everything on the band, and how many people are you coming to, you know, how many people are you going to bring in, how many seconds are you going to sell, and which I understand because it's a business. Their business. So, however. They should do more on promotion. That's their job.
So let me ask you just kind of a follow-up to what Dottie was saying, because I think it's important for bands also to understand that, you know what, there are promoters in this town, but mm-hmm. I mean, we got to talking outside on the break, and you said you've been playing for 15 years?
Yeah.
Okay, so in your 15 years, I mean, obviously you didn't have promoters around you at all times.
Right.
And you were still keen and interested in getting your name out there.
Right.
So how important is it as an up-and-coming artist for all those that are listening out there mm-hmm. to promote themselves?
Absolutely. Because you have to. That's part of the... Right. Yeah, that's part of how it works. And you basically whore yourself out so that as many people who can hear your music and get to know you as an artist, you know, can have access to that. And yeah, as you're a new artist, yeah, you're going to play a lot of free shows. You need to.
Actually, there's from the internet, sure. Tony Martin's, not Tony Martin, Tony Martin's, he said the promoter's biggest Tony. Line when stealing from the talent is that it's exposure. And he also said venues will not give a penny from the bar or concessions,
right.
Which goes into another question for me. And as much as we do this, the venues really don't get talked about that much. I think everybody's also a little too scared to say anything that would get them 86. Sure. But don't worry, we have low dozens of viewers.
Such exposure.
What do you see from the general consensus of venues that they're doing right or wrong? What would you like to see?
I mean, are we talking about specific venues in Fresno, or what are we talking about?
Like, I would say, yeah, Central Valley, Fresno specifically, yeah. Okay.
So what I want to see from a venue?
Yeah.
Oh.
Or are they? Are you mm-hmm. happy with where you've been?
Am I? I've come very, very far in a very short amount of time, because I've been only a full-time for a year and a half. And like you say, I really have to step on eggshells on this one. There are good and bad venues, and I talk to venue owners and I listen to them, and I understand where they're coming from, because this is an incredibly hard thing to do in the Central
Valley.
Yeah,
very tough business.
And I don't know I really don't know what I should say about what I want personally more from venues. I want them to book my band and pay me $500 a night. That's what I want. But that's, you know. What are you gonna? It's not gonna happen in Fresno, and it might. You know, I mean, it all depends on if we're very new, so we don't really have the draw that we want to have yet here in Fresno. We go other places, Sacramento, Reno, 50 people show up like that. You mm-hmm. know,
just their normal night.
Yeah, it's just their normal night. So it has to do with the demographics, the area, the, you know, the financial situation of the individuals involved, free time. People are really just going out to Netflix. You know, they get off a hard day's work in this Fresno heat. They just want to go home and Netflix, you know. So it's getting people out and getting people interested in the music. So as us, for artists, we just have to work on our craft and try to sound better and be better and bring people out.
All right. Well, follow up with Tony Martins. He said, promoters got to promote. Facebook barely counts. And he also says venues are new age pimps. They rarely even give free drinks.
You know, it used to be, I mean, just in the 15 years I've been playing venues, I have seen a big change from them being just, you know, very hospitable. Let's go with that. Venues being more hospitable to the performers. And yeah, we have a lot of people who don't sound good, but they're really trying, you know, so just be a little bit more hospitable. I mean, we go to places and it's like you don't even get a free drink. Yeah, not even one beer. So
I think one of our most outspoken guests was Sahab, and he talked about not feeling appreciated for what you do, and F you, I'm performing, I'm working to bring a crowd here.
Right.
Give me a drink. Give me ice. Don't give me a drink ticket and that's it. You know, don't treat me like cattle type of thing. And I think that's the biggest complaint. Bands want to feel appreciated by the venues.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely.
Bands don't want to be treated as a hired act. They want to be treated as a guest, entertaining other guests. That's
yes,
it.
But if you switch it to the band wanting to be a hired band because you want to get paid, there's a little bit that goes with that. You know,
right.
You're not doing a rider. You're not showing up saying, I need three drinks. I need Aquafina. Don't give me that
Hennessy and Pepsi
slushy
machine. Yeah.
You're not showing up there being like, I'm hired. This is what I was here to do. Right. You're showing up being, hey, I'm a guest. I'm here to hang out. Mm-hmm. I'm here to make a good time.
And I'll just interject this because even still, I mean, as a former artist in the Fresno area, what I would say is this. Any venue that the band that I was in that we played, I mean, you know, we always showed up with, like, you know, we had us, and then, like, every, like, venue would be like, well, hey, you know what, we'll kick you out, like, the plus one. Mm-hmm. So you got your plus one because, look, if you've got a girlfriend or a boyfriend or whatever it is, I mean, you busted your ass on this band, you want to get out there and stage on play, right?
All right. Yeah.
And so you've got that one person who's supported you, been in your corner for that entire time, you want to get them in, and that's it. You know, you're not expecting free drinks, but you get that plus one.
Right, yeah.
But then it comes down to artists, and this is what I wanted to ask you. I mean,
plus, just a side note, can we just all agree, having been former musicians here, that that plus one is usually sometimes the only crowd that you play in front of?
Yeah,
as the girlfriend of a musician, like, there's been times where I've been at a show and I look at the other girls around and we're just like, yeah, there's just a, we're just all here.
Well, it is.
Pretty
it
much
is
glorified band practice.
All here for our boyfriends.
Well, no, it's a live band practice with much better equipment.
Right.
Yeah. There you go.
I can hear myself.
Exactly, right? I've got monitors. What I always run was two Yamaha PA speakers.
The struggle is real, bro.
So let's go ahead and try to get, like not a Kanye West writer here, but from a musician perspective, we would all agree you would like the free drinks.
Sure.
The plus one.
Right.
Not so much as I think you would deserve them.
I gotta say,
them.
Free drinks is definitely something. A bar could throw out free drinks, but we've also had some bands in that you can tell, like, that free drinks becomes a liability to that bar.
I think that's why the bars actually say no to free drinks, is because they've had performers that have gotten, like,
yeah, they get all
royally...
Kenneth about it.
Well, I mean, Kenneth. I'm not saying you should have 100 free drinks, you know what I mean?
They get royally hammered
least,
on stage,
you know,
and they start to sound like shit and act like shit.
Yeah. And that's what really happens. You have, you know, these crappy bands that go in with these personalities that are like divas, and, you know, and they ruin it for everyone. And it's like, we're all working, we're all trying, you know, we're all a team, every sound man, every bar manager.
See, there's
everybody.
Where it comes full circle now. Yeah, now we've gone through everything. The bands need to do their part. They need to step up, be professional.
So yeah, if you're not professional, I mean, and there's a lot of unprofessionalism that goes on. So I mean, that's, I don't know, that's probably everywhere.
But before we head to the next part here, new album.
Yeah, we're working on a new album. We just changed halfway through our recording process. We had to change studios, so we're just cycling everything over. So we were hoping to have it out last month, but we all are all over the state, so it's hard to get us all in one spot. And I'd be able to afford that because we're really poor. So, you know,
we can chop up who's poor outside.
Right, yeah. But it's you know... I forgot what was going. Oh, so we moved over studios. We actually did that today. So we're going to be working with a new producer, Vince Warner, who used to host the
Art Hop.
City Limits City Live.
City Limits Live, yeah.
Yeah, the Kino building. FM.
Yeah, exactly. Excuse so he's going to be
where I'm on air right now.
He's got a brand new studio. And so we're going to move everything over there and start working with him and see how soon we can get this album dropped.
All right, well, now comes the interesting part. Unfortunately, Mostar Kevin couldn't make it tonight. He's deep in wood.
Nah.
He's a wood maker guy.
Oh, I get it now.
Yeah. He normally asks the Mostar Kevin questions. Tonight, I'll have to run them.
Great.
So,
it's time for Mole Star Kevin's questions.
All right, so first question.
First question.
Every time I forget.
You have to go get a button.
Never mind. Who's running this ship? The fucking button.
Damn it, sound boy.
I'm just trying to do it justice.
Sound girl at this point.
Worst joke of the night, Dowdy.
Oh, come on. I did a solid Kevin there. All right, gentlemen. Let's go Levi first on this.
All right.
Would you...
Oh, boy.
Never feel physical... Would you want to never feel physical pain ever again... But the next orgasm you have will be so intense that it will kill you. Or get $400 every time you have diarrhea.
Sounds awesome.
Read the first one again.
You never feel physical pain ever again.
Uh-huh.
But the next orgasm you have will be so intense that it will kill you.
I just got that.
Got to have that defibrillator nearby.
That sounds like a pretty good orgasm. I'm just saying, if you got to go out.
Is it worth it?
Yeah. But that orgasm, you're going to, you know, I mean, you're
dead.
Yeah,
well, physical pain, we're used to that here. So I would have to say pass on the death orgasm.
So you're running a money bank out of your ass then.
Right. So, I mean.
That would help your studio.
More soda.
Beer shits, bro. Beer shits. That's all I got to say.
You'll say, man, your diet's
like,
bad.
I'd be really
anyway.
Rich right now, actually. I would have a new PA, a new guitar.
Okay.
6 week millionaire.
You just line up at Rubber Tito's.
That tampon has multi uses.
And a raw asshole.
Just patch that shit up
happens,
with Bondo.
Man.
Where's my marijuana?
Second question.
All right. This goes to our flower child over here.
Nailed it.
Is that her or me?
No, we're looking at you.
Definitely
we're
nailed it.
We're all looking at you.
Shit, fuck.
Mr. Lemon.
You used basil? The words lemon and basil in a sentence and made it make sense. So, no. How would you ask a stranger for a hand job?
possibly with candy.
Okay, now let's stop for a second.
Oh my god, that's great.
That's a red dot. Yeah.
Specifically a band van.
That gets you on a certain. We're already with NSA.
Hold on, hi Washington.
Yeah. Thanks for listening, Washington Jihad and stuff.
We're going to be on CMAC,
What's your favorite?
Well, Laffy Taffy, pull on it. Why not? Is that not good?
It's good for you.
You can't give him a Jolly Rancher. That shit's sticky.
You've really thought this through.
No, I'm drunk.
What's your favorite grade?
Grade?
No, favorite grade. When you're looking at schools.
Fuck.
All right.
Question the third.
Back to Levi.
Yeah.
Age.
Would you rather have 9 lives... But every time you cheat death, you have half your IQ. Oh. Or would you like to jump ahead 8 hours in time once a day, but you will always be surrounded by 30 cats, and 5 of them will likely be dead because of the law of averages.
The fuck?
This is so complicated.
Yes. Mole Star Kevin questions.
Number 2? Because I can't stand stupid people, bro. I can't do it.
He's all...
I get rid of them.
But I can stand 5 dead cats.
Yeah. Shit.
So you have a girlfriend.
Just say by that 9th cat, you got the IQ of 10.
I would go with the first one because I feel like I have enough IQ to spare, and dead kitties are just...
So Vanna would also go with the second one.
It sounds like Vanna's already 8 lives deep.
Well, no, I've heard that question before, and I finally had an answer.
It took her 6
Thank you
months.
For sure.
How have you
an
heard
answer?
That question before?
Admittedly.
It's a very...
She runs in weird circles.
Yeah. Understood.
Admittedly, she's already...
I'm not allowed to talk about
much
it
like
legally.
The cats that died.
Yeah.
Why did I get the dead cat question? That sucks.
Okay, who wants... Who wants the next one?
Give it to me. I don't trust him.
What question are we
apparently
on
I'm
here?
A pedophile.
Question the third.
No, that we just did man. The third.
That's right. That's right.
Press no, the right button, yeah, damn right. it.
Damn it, sound boy.
All right. Shut up.
Fucking Petey. Pregunta cuatro.
Vanna's eating Laffy Taffy right now.
Hand jobs in the fourth segment.
I got right. from a guy in a van.
Oh, shoot.
Levi.
Yep.
But her hand is sore.
Would you
21 days.
My marijuana tampons will be in.
There's, no, 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 no.
That sounds like a horror movie. Oh.
It is.
A okay. Blair Hitch project.
Oh, Levi.
Yeah.
Levi.
Yeah, bro.
Motherfucker. Shut up.
Is that to me again?
Yeah. Totally you.
I need a beer.
Question number
okay.
four.
He doesn't know
got
what
it.
Buttons he's
Would
pressing.
You rather have the power of invisibility, but only when you are naked? No, I'm sorry. Only when you are drunk. Or have the power of mind reading, but only when the person you're reading the mind of is drunk.
Oh, shit.
First one was I'm naked and I'm invisible?
Yes. And drunk.
Take
no,
it.
No. Naked, invisible, and drunk. And the other one is you're sober, but you can read the mind of the drunk person.
Oh, drunk people. It's so annoying, bro. You know? To deal with them every day when I look in the mirror.
So you're drunk. And
who would want
a new
that?
Spin? I got to bring this up to Kevin. So you're drunk looking in a mirror and you're reading your mind and you just. I should
exactly
start a band.
What that sounds like.
Okay. And. Oh God! What question? Oh, what question are we on here, Dowdy?
Five,
seven.
Fuck.
Last one.
I forgot
quarter.
What question number we were on.
Perfect.
Yes, there we go. Works of the drunk. Who's got this? Levi or Flowery?
Give flower
son?
Don't even have flowers on.
Not
today.
Yet.
Just lots of candy.
No, you brought. Actually, no bullshit. You brought flowers to the studio. I am.
Yeah,
open the door.
For a different person.
But you.
What?
This could get weird soon.
What the hell?
Would you rather have?
Don't you know that's in my rider?
Her other hand is sore too.
From riding the rider.
Okay, Laffy Jerky, calm down. Mac, would you like to have the power of flight, but only when you are naked? Or
I already choose that one.
Or
no,
or,
I'm serious. I already choose that one. Oh, unless the next one's really good, because I love being naked and flying.
You need to fucking answer.
Sign me up.
Well, I guess the losing answer was the strength of Superman, but only for 13 minutes after an orgasm.
Yeah, nah, fuck that. I'm tired after that shit.
So the constant ability to fly.
It's a bird. It's a plane. What the fuck?
It's a tiny Asian dick.
But shit, he's fucking 12,000 feet in the air.
Oh, Jeebus.
13 miles high.
Motherfucker's got to use a telescope.
Literally,
I don't give a shit.
And figuratively.
We literally had to use the Hubble to find his penis, but goddammit, he's flying.
Find that man. Test him now.
Okay. It's time to do, let's get some plugs in. Tell us where to find you. Everything you got coming up, especially the wake house.
Sure, yeah. You can find us at tentcitychrist.com, which is TENT. C-I-T-Y. Had to think about that. Christ, as in Jesus Christ, .com.
Yeah. Not with a K.
All right. So tentcitychrist.com, and you can download all our music on our music tab. We got a bunch of free stuff up there right now, which is the precursor to the next album that's coming out. So we're going to re-record a bunch of that stuff. Also, we have, in terms of upcoming shows, this Saturday we're going to be at the Wake House in Reedley. It used to be Kelly's Beach. And we're going to be there doing an outdoor show, a little reggae on the river, which is one of our favorite things to do in life.
All reggae?
No, not all reggae.
Okay, good.
And then we got... Shit. I'm taking your... Your privileges away, Mac.
God damn it, Roadie.
You totally derailed me. Where was I? Oh, yeah. The next Friday, we're going to be in Sacramento at a place called Cupro's. It's a cool little place to hang out at. It's a house. It's it like is. It's like a redone house in Old Town, or not Old Town, just
it is a three-story building, yeah, and the entire awesome. First story is closed off as their storage headquarters. The second story is the first floor, and the third story is the second floor, and it is badass.
And you with the math fucked me up.
Okay. So anyway, so we're playing there on the 16th. On the 17th, we're going to be doing Clovis. Oh boy, what was that called? It's the Clovis Festival. There's some sort of Clovis Festival.
Cowboy hats and boots.
Yeah, something like
that. There
sounds
you go.
Like everything.
I believe it's called Clovis Fest.
I think it. Yes, I. That's right. It
You're
is Clovis
so good.
Fest.
Good All job. You added was Ivel.
Good job, Laffy Jerky.
So I did a little set out there on the 17th.
Taffy, bitch. Laffy Taffy.
I'm trying to work here, buddy.
So is he.
Remember who the talent is.
Yeah, this is why you never go. Never
remember that you said that, bitch.
Hey, Levi, yeah. I'm right there with you, yeah. Man. I got it.
So, what?
Fuck you. No offense, I love you.
Mm-hmm. And he recognized who the talent was here.
Who signs my paycheck?
There is no paycheck.
Oh, God.
No paychecks.
That's oh, why the that's humor funny, is huh? flowing tonight.
Why right. am I here?
Never been a dime.
It's a spiritual paycheck.
It's spiritual. Let the Lord Jesus get you. That's what we're doing.
What was I doing? What was the question?
Where to find you?
Oh,
we got it on the screen too.
We were at Clovis Fest, actually.
I'm not done.
Tell you what. Shh. Oh, one more. Go for it.
That's where you were.
I will mute everyone.
Oh, I see what you were saying. Okay, so Clovis Fest, and then we're back in Sacramento on such and such date. Look at the calendar on the website.
That's it.
I just ran out of fucks.
That's it.
I brought you back to where we were.
TentCityChrist.com. There you go. That's all you need to know. You want to play, right?
Yeah, that'd be great.
How about let's do that?
Okay.
We're going to take a break, yes. Get you set up real fast, and sure. get a couple songs from Tent City Christ here without the roadie. Maybe. We'll see. We'll figure it out. He's got to go plant some flowers and some shit like that. This is the Dirty Daddy Podcast. And
some hemp.
We'll be right back. Live music from Tent City Christ. You work. You work, flower boy.
Ooh, I like the reggae. Bitch, I've been writing so much music. You have awesome. No idea.
I don't have any idea.
Listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm.
All right, we're back here in the Longbox.fm studios, and we've got Tent City Christ playing a couple songs here for you. Enjoy. Take it away.
Thanks, man. I'm going to do a newer one I've been working on. It's not quite done, but we're going to have fun with it.
The sand between my toes. It's not from walking sandy beaches, it's just from running through the desert. My feet are cracked and bleeding. For I know, seek a righteous man. For I know, seek a righteous man. crown upon my head is not for I be king. Just all the malediction raining down on me. For I know, seek a righteous path. For I know, seek a righteous path. And though I fall, I rise. I know I will rise. And though I fall, I rise. Sand between my toes, it's not from walking the sandy beaches, it's from running through the desert. My feet are cracked and bleeding. For I know, seek a righteous path. For I know, seek a righteous path. Okay, so this next song is called Sandals. It's slated to be our new single, which is funny because it's not reggae at all. It has a lot to do with my disillusionment with the current state of affairs of our world leaders. Now, father to father, while you talking to a bush, you owe to yourself, give the flames a second look. It's my lighter fluke, see the speakers on the lawn. For heaven's sakes, put your sandals back on. He said, I thought this ground was holy, but it's clear I've been misled. I didn't do my homework. Now that tempo garden's red. We sacrifice a young guy with like a sound, but we lost his world. We gave it to the 1%, to the 1%, to the 1%, to the 1%. He said, oh, don't be afraid, 'cause in your life you know you're bound to make a lot of mistakes. And he said, oh, toss the wedding rights, you're gonna have to learn to be your own gin city girl. Oh no. Oh, why now, mother to mother, take your hand up off the place. There's definitely no messiah, no one to supplicate. I'm too much of a cynic to believe in human change. Do this before I'm gone. Throw it in their face. Throw it in their face. Throw it in their face. And she said, oh, don't be afraid, 'cause in your life you know you're bound to make a lot of mistakes. She said, toss the wedding rights, father to father while you talking to a bush. You owe it to yourself, give the flames a second look. I can smell a lot of flute, see the speakers on the lawn. For heaven's sakes, put your sandals back on.
The Dirty Dowdy Podcast, online, on Facebook. Just hit up our Facebook page for all things Dirty Dowdy. That's facebook.com/TheDirtyDowdyPodcast.
Hey, what's up? This is Tracy Morgan. When I'm put a baby in your butthole, I'm listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast. Oop, I just dropped a brown shot.
It's the Dirty Dowdy Podcast.
It's the game everyone's been waiting for. That's right, it's Pick a Card. Race, religion, politics, because we've each got an opinion, right? So step on up and let's play that game, Pick a Card.
And yes, we haven't done it in a bit, but it's Pick a Card. Lovely, lovely, amazing game here on the Dirty Daddy Podcast, where we take the beauty that is the freedom of the internet. When news stories are published, people feel like because they have the keyboard, they can say what they want. And maybe you shouldn't. So I'm going to be reading some stories. Some of them are simple, easy stories that have nothing to do with anything in particular. And some of them may have to do with like politics or whatever. But the beauty of it is when you go down the comment section, there's always that person. So you see, there are shot glasses around you that have popsicle sticks. And there are four cards to play. There is the racist card, the Obama card, the political card, and the police brutality card. And now we're going to do two teams. And I've asked the internet during the break to name the teams. And they were a little brutal, I would say. The teams right now, it's going to be Tent City Christ with Flower Boy Basil and and Ben, which apparently they've decided
is the most brutal name on the planet.
No, they called you guys Ragey Christ Basil.
Yes! I love the internet, by the way.
And that leaves that leaves Vanna and Cotty with Kenneth. It's two
we
girls, one ginger.
Obviously have the winning name.
I can live with that.
This is fucking beautiful.
I can totally live with that.
Two girls, one ginger.
I don't think you could live with this at this point.
Oh. So Ben is on their team?
Yes. Yeah, and you're on Kenneth.
Oh, fuck you.
Sorry,
Ben. Oh, fuck Ragey. You.
So wait, I'm on Ragey Basil Christ? Or motherfucker.
It's Ragey Christ, Basil, and it's organic.
You know, yes. Organic.
Ragey Basil Christ is actually a better arrangement of that.
Sounds like a new ride at Magic Mountain, for fuck's sake.
Well, let's get
how
to
savory.
We got to keep
Ragey Basil Christ would make more sense, too, because they're technically God. Tent City Christ. So.
It sounds like a never hippie mind. Band, guys.
Whatever anyone was just doing, don't do that ever again. Let me read the first one. Now, we're going to...
What the fuck was that? Is
that
you?
That was Captain Basil over there. Captain Basil.
What the fuck?
Organic and green.
Well, since you decided to step to the plate, we're going to go Basil Boy versus who wants to step up from two girls, one ginger?
The ginger will step up first.
The ginger is up. All right.
Ladies first.
Get your popsicle sticks in hand, and I mean
fuck
the
yourself,
ones
Vanna.
On the table.
I do.
I know. With a Hello Kitty.
It's a Cheshire Cat.
Still not paying attention. So here it goes. The story is, and Vanna, you would love this. Apple CEO Tim Cook and company are hosting a major press event in San Francisco today where they're taking the wraps off the new iPhone 7 and Apple Watch 2. And here we are live bringing you all the news as it happens. Yeah, that was weird. Going down the comments, can you guess which card was pulled? Kenneth?
I'm going to go say the Obama card.
Obama card. And reasoning?
No.
Okay.
I like you.
Yeah.
And Ragey Basil.
I not only don't understand the game, but I don't understand the question.
Which?
That was beautiful. Can we get that as a sound clip?
By the way, where am I?
All right. LSD is bad, man. Just know that. The question is, what was the first the commenter who had to make a statement? Whether it be in political, police brutality, Obama, or race. Pick a card. What? You're a millennial. This is totally in your wheelhouse.
So you know how people make comments?
Yeah, like assholes.
What's the first comment?
What would the asshole comment be? Would it be racist? Would it be... You have to guess.
About?
Yes.
About what I just read.
Twice.
The new iPhone 7.
All right, so...
he follows a reggae band. I'm sorry.
Weed is not your friend, man.
All right, so... We're gonna
understand.
Reggie Basil Christ is gonna go with the racism.
Come no,
that's wrong.
He's pulling political.
Oh, you're shit. On it. You're on his team, and he's answering.
Like I was going with the little house.
I'll tickle your nipples, bitch.
Ben, what are you on doing? On the prairie.
I like the one with pillars.
This is gonna be a short game.
This one's vertical.
Welcome to the Short Bus Podcast here on Longbox.fm. The answer
yellow
was from Phil. Phil says the GOP isn't going to like this. They have done nothing for jobs or the economy in 8 years. It is politics. And with that,
good job.
And
Basil boy,
pulled it out.
Fucking Phil.
Yeah, no, Vanna, you always pull it out first.
No, this is two dicks.
He doesn't even know.
He's definitely got all the raging.
Point goes to Ragey Christ Basil.
Yeah.
Specifically, right. Mr. Basil.
All right. So, Cotty, Vanna, you're up next for the two girls, one ginger. Versus, yeah. Let's go with our guest, Levi.
Okay.
The story as it goes. History is filled with stories of criminals or wannabe criminals who aren't that bright. And we have a couple more to add to the list. According to the New Orleans Advocate, last year, then-New Orleans Saints defensive coordinator Rob Ryan was apparently the target of a robbery plan, but a voicemail left for the wrong person thwarted it. Which card was pulled in the comment section?
That's racist.
Racism from Vanna. Vanna's the racist here. And Levi?
I'm going to go with racism.
We got a double racism. The answer was from I know, because he couldn't put his actual name. It's called The Hood, because it's made up of a lot of hoodlums. It amazes me how the black community can just look away.
Nailed it.
When a very large percentage within are involved in criminal enterprise and violence as a way of life. The biggest mistake society keeps making is thinking that white people and the police will have any kind of solution to the black community's self-inflicted oppression. The blacks don't want no whitey solutions, and they don't want cops in their hood. These
Thanks,
are the two
Obama.
Worst things to do, both only inflame. Yes, it is racism. Thank you.
Yeah.
Throwing in hood and whitey.
Should just be zero and zero.
Points go to both. All right, and that leads to Cuddy versus Ben.
Dum, dum, dum.
A battle of the C team.
It's at least the D team, bro.
Harsh.
The roast of Rob Lowe aired Monday on Comedy Central. And not only did Roaster and Coulter, by the way, will be on KMJ tomorrow.
I saw that.
Get a lot of.
By the way, instead of Van Coulter, if you want to get Vanna Vandal, just call Coulter.
That was hilarious. How fucking.
Again, we're talking when I'm talking, and that's a thing we don't do here.
totally.
And not only did Roaster and Coulter get a lot of insults thrown her way, but her own jokes fell flat. Roasting Lowe with veteran stand-up talents like David Spade and Roast King Jeff Ross, the conservative commenter, should have taken some of the jokes the show's writers compiled for, as many non-comics who go on the roast do. With that start of that story, what card is being pulled? We got on the camera there from Cotty. Political.
Because she's just now
so
stopping
political.
Talking.
And Ben's going with a safe political as well.
No, I have to. I saw it.
Oh, shit.
Well,
so then you admit
the
you're
answer.
Cheating?
No, the
no,
answer.
No, I saw it. I can't cheat. Show.
Jesus Christ, I'm going to punch all of you guys in the vaginas.
No, Tent City Christ.
Tent City Christ, I'm going to punch all of you in the vaginas.
I don't have one.
Well, Basil.
He'll still punch it.
Lemon. Shut up!
I might like it.
My soul hurts.
He's got a free candy van outside, ladies and gentlemen.
And that's a taffy.
This matches the feeling I got when my son pooed in the tub when he was taking a bath. You're just sad, and you also know you have to pick it up later and make something good out of it.
That was your last
make
night.
Make something good of
I will.
How do you make
it? Yeah, I'll put it in
Fridays.
I'll put it in the dirt and plant some basil lemon.
Thank you. That's all I'm asking.
Wheatgrass.
That's a shitty plant.
Nope.
It smells beautiful.
Nope. Nope, Kenneth.
It deters insects.
Lemon basil. Bitches. Shut up.
Just. I'm liking you less and less.
We're liking him more and more.
I can't take you anywhere, Roddy.
I'm sorry.
No, you're not.
The yes. answer!
Is political?
The only thing flatter than Ann Coulter's performance is Trump's approval rating with the blacks.
Oh, is that racist?
Oh.
That's entirely political.
No,
well,
points.
He said Trump, but he's not really a politician.
Well, racism is actually a political issue when you really think about it.
You know, separate the we're all drunk. Thanks, Riley's. And, so,
now is not
the time to be splitting hairs.
How are you going to compare the fucking failure of two white people and not call it political?
So the next question.
Damn, that was a stink.
We're going Levi versus Vanna.
All right.
Trump's bombastic campaign to lead the Republican Party to the November presidential election has alarmed some Americans, both liberals and those in his own party. And the pledge by some to move to Canada if he is elected has gathered steam. Pick a card.
Just pick one?
So quiet.
Thanks, Obama.
That's it?
Obama from Levi. What do you got, Vanna? She's pulling up the house. Political. The answer, coming from Y, again, good job with your name. Canada is dumping grounds for cowards, traitors, and all sorts of people of ill repute. America haters abound there. America haters abound there, even though... Remember, I'm reading what they type, and it's
not... That's not Kenneth laughing, by the way. That's Ben from The Kick.
I thought it was Monday. Kenneth.
I did, too.
I'm reading word for word here.
I haven't laughed in a solid 2 minutes.
This hurts my brain. America haters abound there, even though America provides their self-defense. As Canada sucks off American taxpayers, our traitors want to flee there. The only drawback to sending our traitors to Canada is they will breed like rats and become Canadian rats. Unfortunately for Canada, all Muslims, Muslims, and lowlives, they
don't
let in...
Don't be so damn racist, well,
Muslims.
You say Muslims?
Muslims. That's how it's written. They let...
You wrote it.
They No. No.
No, the viewers did.
This is not me.
I can't even tell what it would be because this fucker God. Can't write.
He spelled Kunisama as one word.
Canada will go down as Europe is going down to the world's rejects and evildoers. This is definitely race.
Damn. No, but like I said before,
Everything's political to you. You're a millennial. Next question.
Obama is a race, though, right?
And you.
And
Obama is a what?
He's a race, though, right?
Obama
that counts.
Is a race.
Wow. Is that a check mark on the box? Wow. You're about
it's
to
right
check mark
your
ethnicity, Obama.
Right.
So literally, you tell me you were going to vote for a white Obama or a black Obama. Is that how it's going to go?
That might be possible.
Well.
Oh, no.
Okay. Cloning.
No Obama.
Look, this game's not going well for anyone.
Christ Basil is winning.
That's ragey Christ Basil.
Yeah, ragey, bitch.
Ragey.
Ragey.
Wow.
Okay.
Holy fuck.
Let's go.
I'm sorry.
Let's go 60s Flower Girl.
Oh.
No,
oh,
that's you. That's you. You had your arm up right.
I knew
making
it wasn't
sure.
Versus Captain Ragey himself, Ben.
Yes.
Because you got to put a flower girl up against Rage.
Wait, I thought Ben was on their team.
So if
Wait,
hold on.
Yeah.
Can I ask a question about the next question?
Oh, fuck.
I will still do this.
Why are we making this so goddamn difficult? We're trying to do this.
Never mind. I digress.
That's a song.
You know, you talk to me about being a loud fucker. But right across from me.
Please ask the
question. You can't see me on camera right now, but I'm actively repressing. So, okay, sorry. Flower Girl Mac and Vanna.
Go on.
Vanna just went.
I just went, but I'll go again.
Oh, Cotty.
What?
Okay. Well, Cotty.
He's avoiding me. He is totally avoiding me.
Just pay attention. Oh, my God.
What?
We're going to skip.
The ginger.
The question is, or the story is, a New Yorker woman was arrested after she allegedly bit an employee at a Vermont store after he attempted to retrieve underwear she had allegedly stolen from the store. Pick a card.
What?
We got police brutality from Flower Girl and racism from Cotty. Of course, the Mexican throws racism up there. The answer...
That was racist.
This was funded by a white guy, by the way. Alinsky. Jesus.
Funding. We have no funding.
The answer from Rick was, why didn't he shoot her? Oh, only cops shoot unarmed people. Police brutality!
I'm a genius!
Yeah, buddy!
Point.
Our team is so fucked.
And definitely a much needed a mercy kill here. The point and victory goes to Ragey Christ Basil.
Woo! Yeah.
Can we still change that to Ragey Basil Christ?
Yeah, I'll do it in post-production.
I like being in front of Levi.
I think you like to be in... Yeah.
Sorry, Levi likes to give it from the back.
Yeah.
That's why I don't let you talk.
Hey, can we give 10...
Levi,
fucking done! Okay,
Levi can't pour vodka into his dick for a year.
It's not enough vodka.
If he drinks enough...
I can pour vodka.
Into a strap-on?
Oh, no.
No.
Did you even listen to the predecessor sentence?
All I heard was pour vodka.
So, Preceding sentence.
Prior to that, it involved me in front and him in back.
So we were going to be on CMAC.
God damn it.
Wow. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the Dirty Daddy Podcast. We'll be right back with the mercy kill that is the Tardies. Holy crap.
Listening to the Dirty Dowdy Podcast on Longbox.fm. This segment of the show is brought to you by AudioWorks Sound, Stage, and Lighting. Check them out for your next event. Go to their website, AudioWorksFresno.com, and give them a call for your event needs. Make YouTube your tube by searching out Longbox.fm on YouTube.com. It's music, videos, and live webcasts. Watch it all at YouTube.com by searching out Longbox.fm.
All right, dirty. Oh my God!
What a
okay. Awful fuck. Everything was going as smooth as HSR, and then
I knocked over the guitar.
Yeah. You had one job
to ruin the guitar.
you don't have to scream into the mic.
He put my gaff tape on the guitar.
You were going Ben Affleck on that mic.
I'm Flower Boy.
I'm Batman.
They call me Lemony Basil. I occasionally fuck Ben or Matt Damon.
Matt Damon.
Okay, this is the Dirt Daddy Podcast. Thank you for the world who is still listening.
Is that a South Park reference?
Thank you, soul listener.
We are brought to you by Riley's Brewing and
cheers
tonight with the food, which has not calmed anyone down. Cooney Salmon, check him out. Herndon and Willow, the corner of in the Walmart parking lot. And with that, we got to talk about the wrap up of tonight's show. Kenneth, are you ready for your stuff?
Yes, please, God.
I want to hear some Slayer.
Okay, I'm going to really have to reconsider who I bring in on this week to week.
Yeah.
We are doing the Tardies, as you can see
is
on the screen.
Is that man?
That is Kenneth right there.
That's Kenneth?
That is Kenneth.
That's Dick's a lot smaller than I imagined.
So you were imagining.
Plenty.
Okay.
That makes
not that I don't imagine about women.
Oh, God, shut up.
He's got smaller tits, too.
And it is time for the Tardies, ladies and gentlemen. Go.
He's got a hashtag. He's got smaller tits. He's wearing a Wonder Bra.
Kenneth, I love you.
Hit it, Ken.
Take it.
We have the Tardies tonight, and my God, what a clusterfuck tonight is. Oh, my God. We start off with the hashtag of the night, and there weren't very many hashtags, but the ones that did make it, kind of had to just throw them in here. We, of course, had DDP Live and Make Fresno Better, and then there was Blinded by the Light, but I think the winner of the night went to Laffy Jerky, which actually was Chris Dowdy.
Yay!
Yay, he won something. He also wins the worst joke of the night.
Yeah.
Now's not the time to be splitting hairs.
Oh, that.
I still don't
no, no,
get it.
I'm giving you that.
Yeah, you want to give it to me.
Nah, nobody does.
You just want secondhand Cotty.
Wait, oh, what?
Next one.
This is repulsive.
We, of course, have a quote of the day today, and that actually goes to Levi of Tent City Christ. I just ran out of fucks. Much like most of us did about this show tonight.
Yeah.
At about 6:30.
Appropriate.
We have a best moment of the night, and that goes to Molestar's questions, but the winner of that actually goes to Mac, Mr. Lemony Basil himself.
Oh, no.
Yeah, jeez. Who also wins the fucking retard of the night.
Well, that
this
happens.
Is archived, I hope.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to be a fucking world champion.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what we'll call it. Champion.
You
anyway,
set the bar high.
We have a Clam Joke Award winner, and that actually goes to Vanna. They what? Aren't Pokemon. You don't need to catch them all. That's for her STD story.
Yeah.
And she also happens to be the winner of the final award of the night, the MVP award, for her very pretty Motley Crue collage. Aww. Good job, Vanna.
Really hard on it.
So
yay.
Pretty. So fucking
can we
pretty.
Can we rename so that the participation pretty. Ribbon?
Yes, we will give her a ribbon. I don't know when we'll have it developed.
Huh. I can sew one.
Just because I don't want to hear Vanna for
it
a minute.
Like
I'm giving it to Dowdy.
I get it.
You get a minute.
I get a minute?
What?
I get. Oh, this is perfect because I had something to talk about.
No.
Okay, here we go. Here we go.
No.
Are you guys ready? Race. Oh, we're getting cards. Okay, here's.
Bring it, you fucking.
You got carded.
Bring
shut
it, you
up,
fucking
it's
half
my
man.
Moment.
Fucking half man. Bring it.
I hate you guys all so much. So here's my thing. Make Fresno Better has been a thing, the hashtag that we've been trying to push for a long time. And we live in a city and a town.
Here we go.
That doesn't push it.
No. But I will. And I'll start it with the black woman who was at 7-Eleven today.
Fuck.
With Star Wars music?
Yeah.
No.
Wrong movie. So the woman at 7-Eleven today who got in line, the only cashier during a busy time, and while she puts her stuff on the table, on the counter, saying, I want to buy this, 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 and then asks her right, as a citizen in a capitalist society, her phone rings.
Ooh.
Yeah.
That would piss me off.
Now, hold on. No, I... Okay, so I lost my job.
Oh, fuck.
But I can fit you in, and... hold on. As she's talking to the cashier. No, like, I'm too busy right now, don't you see? And by the way, two taquitos.
What the fuck?
And all of us are setting light, and everyone is super patient. Now, my version of make Fresno better is to be patient, to hold the door open, to smile.
That sounds like there's but a no. butt.
No, bitch, please. I am staring you down. I pull out my phone.
Bye, Felicia.
As I stare at her. Hi, sorry, I can't order and pay for my shit. Because I got a person who's way too important. We got the Kanye West of Fresno hoes sitting up in here at 7-Eleven at 4:55 on a goddamn afternoon.
Yes!
And that was the phone call I received from Dowdy today.
And she's going, now my nail's been updid. I'm like, you can updid the fucking bill. Or get out of goddamn line. And as I'm doing that on my phone, just passively, aggressively staring at her face. Very aggressive! The crowd got into it! There were people in the line just like, no, nah, you need to go. You need to go.
Oh my god!
This is why I gave him a minute.
And she got mad.
I could see that.
And she walked out.
Did she pay?
She got nothing.
What?
I was next in line.
Yeah.
I got a Red Bull.
What a champion.
I got cigarettes.
Freedom. The world champion.
And my EBT paid for half of it.
Woo. So
and
I
the people behind
it.
Me. Got their purchases soon after. Thank you, thank you. That's how you make Fresno better.
Yes, sir.
You call out the bullshit. You smile. You hold the door open. But if someone's a bitch, you go. You go get them, girl.
So with that, Vanna wins the MVP. Can I?
So with that, Tent City Christ.
Give us make Fresno ghetto.
One more time. How do we find you as a band and all the things coming up?
www.tentcitychrist.com. That's the best way. All our music up there, our fan. Not, we don't have those, but someday we'll have a fine. All our shows and everything is on there, and free music to download. So,
fantastic. And your show at the Wake House, September 10th?
That is coming up this Saturday. It's going to be from 9 to 1 p.m. in the morning, so reggae on the river.
1 a.m.
And that's what I meant. Actually, not a bad venue.
It's great.
It's different. You're not going to Fulton 55. You're not going to Strummer's and that type of cement walls and scenery. It's actually a very chill local.
Yeah, it's cool.
You drive a little bit,
but
you get...
It's organic.
Okay, see, and that's why I know he loves this venue. Yeah. You may lose him there.
Again, worthy of his award.
He'll lose himself there. Is that Bullfrogs?
No, that's it's Kelly's Beach.
Kelly's Beach. Yeah. Oh, no, you were telling me about that. Okay. All right, perfect.
Well, I guess with that, thank you, everyone, for tuning in. You can see this on CMAC.
You might not want to.
After listening tonight.
Chris.
Slightly inappropriate.
Okay, hold on. Ben, what?
I don't want to see your thunder. I just want to say thank you to Trap City Jesus. And I want to say thank you to Jared Leto from Dallas Buyers Club.
I'm so grateful. So grateful.
Such
thank
a
you.
Joker. Oh, come on. All right.
The words are over, asshole.
I think he meant we should be so grateful.
Next week, we have somebody coming in. I don't know, but it's going to be awesome. Actually, I have a couple. There's a couple people I'm talking to, so this could be good. And especially for the ladies here. Vanna and Cotty, I'll talk to you after the show. We might have something really cool happening for you guys.
Shut the fuck up.
And marijuana tampons.
I want to say thank you to Riley's Brewing and of course Kunisama. Go support your local businesses, local groups, all that stuff. And this is Dowdy saying for everyone else in the room, and let me do this on air too with New Rock 104 right now. Word.
Peace, bitches.
Dude, I say word all the time, and people don't get
me.
People don't get you.
That's not why.
They don't get you when that's not the only thing you're saying. Holy
come on now. I'm notorious for saying palabras, but Jesus Christ. I mean, fuck.
Nah,
this is why I thought I had different.
No, Tent City Christ. I thought we went over that.
Hey.
That looks like you got scratched by an animal.
I did.
Are you a word?
Slab City Savior? Did I? Was that not a thing?
That is You're a word, dog.
Good. I like that.
Slab City Savior? Come on, now. But I think Tin City Price rolls off the tongue a little bit better.
Did Maybe. You say Slab City?
Slab.
I've noticed slab. That it is very difficult for people to get right.
Right? I think like you should probably come up with all the different ways to say.
Let me get a picture of everyone. Yeah.
I'm gonna stay. Ah! I'm gonna stay in the chair.
Yeah.
Just gonna stay in the chair.
You mean like every week?
No, last week I stood up. This week I'm staying in the chair.
Congrats, man.
You know what? Like you know which card you're missing?
You're like the guy from
sushi
from,
roll card.
Kids.
By the way, some miso. Roll one for me.
I'm
now.
Good. Thank you. Right. I don't need
you. You probably went outside.
Do you need some
You need a card with the sushi roll on it.
Everyone get in the goddamn picture.
Mac!
What is it?
Vanna!
Mac, you're worse than Cuddy. That's not a good thing.
Woo!
Vanna. Vanna, come here. Come
Hello, Vanna's looking come pretty.
Let's do it without sucking your bottom eyelids into other? Your face.
What does that even mean?
I know. They're all so mean. Especially that ginger. Look at that ginger right there. Two girls, one ginger.
That's natural. I'm just a fucking asshole.
All right, everybody get
out of Everybody knew this upon meeting me.
What?
Oh, Jesus.
Come here. Okay, everybody, like, look. Like,
what I was like, that feels like more than a human.
It looked like Vanna, or like Flower Boy was blowing Vanna, who was blowing a dog.
Yeah.
And it was. What?
That was a. Okay, look at the camera.
No!
Oh, Jesus, I don't give a shit anymore. This is what we're doing. Okay.
I ran out of butts.
I definitely.
For fuck's sake.
Like, oh, fuck.
I literally did, too. I just didn't want to talk anymore.
I'm throwing them all up right now. This whole show was a whole bunch of all of this shit right here.
I realize I shouldn't get high before I
How you year. Feeling, Ben?
Fucker. Swear to God, that's a new Obama right there. Just sitting back in the corner. Liberal bastard.
Come here, pup.
No,
let's get the power to the people.
Let's put radio on air.
Yes.
And look,